And then she sees, and the Bible says she sees Isaac a long way off, and he's meditating. So Isaac then was a kind of person who spent a lot of time, we can extrapolate from this, in prayer and meditating. He wasn't a talkative person, he's someone who was a very inward kind of person. You can imagine he had a lot to reflect about in terms of his experience with Abraham, his dad getting sacrificed. And then when Rebecca saw him, then it says that Rebecca covers her face with her veil. So again, it's like she's creating some kind of barrier between him and her. So from these kind of things, it looks like maybe Rebecca was overawed, maybe Isaac was some kind of great person in her eyes, and she felt when she was very small and couldn't really talk to him, I don't know. But anyway, there's something problematic in this relationship. Then, as I said, Rebecca dominates Jacob. Jacob doesn't follow his conscience, and then Jacob goes in and deceives his father. Okay, so this is basically the four great realms of heart in this family. No. Brother, brother? No. Husband, wife? No. Parent, children? No. Okay? These four great realms of heart haven't been established in this family. And that's why Satan was able to invade, you could say. Aspect wasn't very good. Oh yeah, this is what I talked about. The big gap of age, maybe Rebecca was all by Isaac, and etc. etc. Okay, now what's interesting then is to move on and have a look at the blessing that Isaac wanted to give to Esau that Jacob stole, because it wasn't his. He stole his older brother's blessing. And this is what Isaac said. This is Isaac. This is the blessing Isaac wanted to give to Esau. May God give you heaven's dew and earth's richness, abundance of grain and new wine. May nations serve you and peoples bow down to you. Be lord over your brothers and may the sons of your mother bow down to you. May those who curse you be cursed and those who bless you be blessed. Now what do you think about the spiritual quality of this blessing? Or religious quality? What's his blessing? What are the main things this blessing is about? Heaven's dew, earth's richness, abundance of grain and new wine. It's about wealth. It's about material prosperity, the first part of the blessing. And the second part, lord over your brothers, may sons of your mother bow down to you. Peoples bow down to you. It's about power, yes? Being a ruler. Okay? It's about wealth and power. Is it a particularly spiritual blessing? Anyway, when Esau came back, he found that Jacob had taken and stolen his blessing. Esau gets really angry and upset, and he wants to kill his brother, Jacob, yet he says, I'm going to wait till, you know, dad dies, and I'm going to go and kill him. So Esau actually was a good person. He loved his father. He didn't want to make his parents heartbroken by killing his younger brother while they were still alive. So he said, I'm going to wait till they die, and then I'm going to go and sort it out with my younger brother. So do you think Esau was justified in feeling upset and angry with Jacob?
Oh yes.
Yeah.
Yes. I mean, you know, if your younger brother, who kept on getting up your nose your whole life and annoying you and being a little, real arrogant little prick, went and stole your share of the inheritance, you'd be really angry. Yes? No. So there's no foundation substance there. So should it happen this way? Okay, so this is what Mrs. Yu said, the wife of the author of Viking School, former president of the Korean Church, who said, Jacob tricked Esau twice in order to take Esau's elder sonship. Once with a lentil soup, that's not a trick, he bought it, and tricked him again when receiving Isaac's blessing. However, that actually wasn't the correct way according to the principle. So Jacob wasn't supposed to buy the birthright, he should have won it the way I said. He wasn't supposed to deceive and trick his brother in order to get his blessing. Had Jacob wanted to inherit the rights of the elder son, he should have served and behaved well to his older brother. Then the older brother's son's heart would have been moved. He would have said, yes, you are not only smarter than me, but better in every aspect, so you should be my elder brother. Jacob brought his older brother into natural subjugation like this. So much could have been solved in the course of indemnity. Okay, so what happened was a mistake. Wasn't supposed to deceive his father, wasn't supposed to do this, this and this and this. Okay? It happened, but it wasn't supposed to. Okay, one problem in our own spiritual community is that the way the story is normally being told is that Jacob was supposed to deceive his father and Rebecca was supposed to deceive her husband to restore the fall. Yes? Restoration is not repetition. Yeah? All that happened was the same thing was repeated, not restored. Okay, it shouldn't have happened. And for some peculiar reason, we misteach the story in our own spiritual community such that, you know, people have thought the end justified the means. And it's okay to deceive and to do this, this, and this, and this, because, you know, that's what Jacob did, and it's okay. Okay? Mother-son cooperation. Okay, so what should have happened then? Rebecca should have restored Eve and Sarah's role by helping her sons to love each other. So, normally when, is it natural for siblings to fall out with each other over Lego bricks or over something?
Yeah.
Yes, that's just the way it is. Do you think if there'd be no fall, children still have squabbles about whose doll this is?
Yeah.
Yes. Okay, so the role of parents then is to teach their children, okay, what's going on here? Whose doll is it? Or whose Lego brick is it? Well, it's yours. Okay. You want to play with it, but did you ask your brother or sister who owns it if they could? No, I didn't. Well, in that case, no wonder they're upset. Okay, so you need to ask permission, and then you who owns it, it'd be nice if you shared it. Okay, so, you know, please apologize to each other, forgive each other, make up, and try and work out a way that you can actually play happily together. Yep. Do you think Eve did that with Cain and Abel?
No,
probably not. Do you think Rebecca did that with Esau and Jacob? No, so there's a mistake there. Okay, so Rebecca then favoured Jacob based on her dream. Is it okay to have a favourite son or daughter? No, what happens if you have a favourite?
Jealousy.
Is that a good thing? It's incredibly destructive, yeah? So it's not a good thing. So, but Rebecca though, loved Jacob, and so how do you think Esau felt about his mum favouring his younger brother? Not happy. And so Esau then is orientating more towards Isaac. But anyway, at least though, Rebecca saved Jacob's life by sending him to Haran. So his father said, the way of the mother Eve was to unite Cain and Abel and bring them to Adam. So unfortunately Rebecca wasn't able to do that. Not easy, these things. Anyway, so Rebecca says to Jacob, go and stay with my brother, Laban. And before Jacob goes, he goes to see and say goodbye to Dad. And then Isaac then blesses Jacob. Now let's read this blessing that Isaac wanted, that Isaac gave to Jacob. May God Almighty bless you and make you fruitful and increase your numbers until you become a community of peoples. May he give you and your descendants the blessing given to Abraham, so that you may take possession of the land where you now live, as an alien, the land God gave to Abraham. What do you think about this blessing?
It's a serious one.
Yeah. What elements in there can you recognize? Be fruitful, multiply, have dominion. These are the three great blessings that God gave to Adam and to Noah. But also, you know, may he give you the blessing given to Abraham. Okay? Have possession over the land. So this is the birthright blessing. Okay. So what was the problem? Isaac had it all worked out in his head. I want to bless both of my sons, Esau and Jacob. I want to bless Esau first because he's the eldest son. And then if I give him a blessing he's happy and satisfied with, then when I give a blessing to Jacob, then my eldest son Esau won't get jealous. Whereas if I bless my youngest son first before my oldest son, this would create all kinds of problems and jealousies. So Isaac had it all worked out in his head. He knew Jacob had the birthright. That's why he was going to give him the birthright blessing. Either Jacob told him that he bought it, or Esau told him he'd sold it. He knew. Yeah? That's why he was going to give Jacob the birthright blessing. So Isaac had it all worked out in his head. The only problem was what? He didn't communicate and explain to Rebecca. So when Rebecca overheard Isaac talking to Esau, Rebecca got the wrong end of the stick. She thought, my stupid old husband, he's going to give everything to Esau. But I got a dream that Jacob's the one who should get the blessing. And And so she went off with her own plan, yes? To arrange for Jacob to get Esau's blessing. So she didn't understand what Isaac had worked out in his head, which is exactly the right thing, but he hadn't communicated it with his wife. Yes? And so Jacob then ended up not only getting his own blessing, which is the one he deserved and was his by right, he also ended up getting Esau's blessing. So he didn't just get his share of the inheritance, he got the whole lot. And so naturally, Esau was not best pleased. And as a result, Esau nearly killed Jacob. It's like almost a repetition of Cain killing Abel. So Isaac had worked really hard to try to work these things out, but he hadn't spoken to Rebekah. That was his big mistake, not exploring any of his plans to his wife. And then Rebekah, not, etc. So you can't say that one particular person failed. There's a breakdown at all these levels. Isaac made a mistake, Rebecca made a mistake, the relationship between Isaac and Rebecca wasn't the way it was supposed to be. Jacob made a mistake, the relationship between parents and Rebecca and Jacob wasn't huge. Rebecca was too controlling over Jacob, and Jacob was too, doing what his mother told him to do, instead of following his conscience. And Esau, did Esau do anything wrong? Esau was just being Esau. Yes? You know what I mean? He was just a very simple person, a good-hearted person. But he wasn't as intelligent as his younger brother, who used to run rings around him. Yes? That makes sense? He was just a nice, good-hearted person who loved his parents. And, Rebecca said to Isaac, I want Jacob to go and get married to one of the people from back home, from our family, because I can't stand these Canaanite women that Esau's got married to. They're driving me nuts with their smells or their cooking or whatever. And when Esau overheard this, what did he do? He went and married Ishmael's daughter. He didn't realize, I didn't realize my parents didn't like my wives. But when he did realize, he went and married Ishmael's daughter. Yeah? He was a good-hearted person, but it's not the brightest spark in that sense. That makes sense? It was interesting trying to unwrap these things and to think, how can one be a good older brother? How can one be a good younger brother? Yes? So there's the original nature of Cain, the older brother, and the original nature of Abel. There's the fallen nature of the younger brother, being arrogant and boastful and not respecting his older brother. And there's the fallen nature of the older brother. He gets so sick and fed up with the younger brother, he can beat his brains out and bully him. Okay? So should Jacob have gone to Haran? That's what Father said. Did Jacob as Abel become really one with Esau as his Cain, thus subjugating Satan completely, not originally? Jacob should have won his blessing in his native home in total harmony with Esau and not have had to go to Haran. However, he had to escape from the danger brought about by Esau's intention to kill him, thus the condition of death is not completed. Okay, so it wasn't supposed to go to Haran. That was a mistake, yeah? As a result of Jacob's earlier mistake. And the other people's, So he goes off to Haran, saw the three blessings there, becomes a person of character, gets married, has 12 sons and one daughter, acquires great wealth, and then after 21 years, he goes home. But on the way, there's something very interesting happens. When he arrives, he went there, and you remember he wanted to get married to Rachel, a pretty daughter of Laban, and he says to Laban, can I marry your daughter Rachel? And Laban says, yes, just work for me for 7 years. Okay? He works for 7 years, and then they have a wedding, and of course the bride is covered in all these veils, you can't see who she is. And then when the morning comes, the sun rises, he's lying in bed, and he looks over, and he sees it was Leah. And Jacob said to Laban, what is this you've done to me? Did I not serve you for Rachel? Why then have you deceived me? But Laban said, this is not done in our country, you being the younger, before the firstborn. Complete the week of this one, and we'll give you the other also in return for serving me for another 7 years. So what's happened here is that the father, Laban, and Leah, the daughter, have deceived Jacob. Why did it happen? This is not done in our country, giving the younger before the firstborn. In other words, Laban is saying to Jacob, I know what you did to your older brother. We don't treat our older brothers in the way that you treated your older brother. like this is payback time for the way I treated my older brother Esau. So Jacob's been reminded that he treated his father and older brothers wrong. So if Jacob then had not stolen Esau's blessing, then he would have got married at the right time and only ended up with one wife. Yeah, should Jacob have had two wives? How many wives did Abraham have? One. How many wives did Isaac have? One. That was the tradition, yes? One wife, one man, one woman, yeah? So was Jacob supposed to have two wives? No, he should only have had one wife. So the reason why he ended up with two wives was what goes around comes around. It's like, sort of, you know, he's being treated the way he treated Esau is the way he found himself getting treated in return. And that caused huge difficulties. Anyway, so Jacob went into Rachel also, and he loved Rachel more than Leah. Actually, doesn't say that in the Hebrew. It says he loved Rachel and he hated Leah. Now, how do you think life was like for? How do you think they felt, all this family now? How do you think Rachel felt? She'd been waiting for 7 years, making all the wedding dresses and everything, and then on the day of the wedding. Her dad probably comes along and locks her up somewhere, so she can't go to her own wedding. How do you think Rachel feels to be treated like that by her father? So later then, she wrecked and ruined, he ruined Rachel's life. Her whole marriage was hell. How do you think Leah felt? That, you know, a week later, Jacob, her husband, married her younger sister, and Jacob loved her younger sister and hated her. How do you think Leah felt?
Put down.
The pain in this family is unimaginable. And how do you think Jacob felt? You know, to be treated like this. All of them had to deal with this incredible pain. Yes? And manage this incredible situation, this incredible pain. Of being deceived and tricked. And Jacob had to come to terms with it, realizing, yes, the reason it's turned out like this is because I was such an immature person and I tricked and deceived my older brother. And the way what's happening to me now I can understand why my older brother was so upset and angry with me. Yeah? Etc. Really painful. What goes around comes around. And then 10 times later, treated Jacob out of his wages. So Jacob understood, you know, he'd been tricked out of his wages 10 times. Laban said, okay, at the beginning of the year, this is the contract. And the end of the year, and you get paid this. At the end of the year, Laban says, well, actually, this and 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 this. Therefore, I'm only going to give you half your wages. Yes? 10 times Jacob's tricked out of his wages. Why didn't he go and kill his uncle? He had to deal with this experience of incredible injustice. He had to digest this injustice and deal with it and not become resentful and bitter and angry and lose his temper and go and murder his uncle. Very difficult things that these people had to deal with and digest and process. Very hard. But they managed it, which is why we're reading about them. Yeah? They were successful. So Jacob then changed, as father said. He felt sorry for what he'd done to his elder brother. He thought it was understandable for Esau to want to kill him when he'd taken away the birthright by cheating him. He was sympathetic with his brother. So Jacob then felt sympathy for his older brother. Okay. And he decided, after 21 years, to go back and meet Esau. 21 years later. Now, you've heard of Clement and Lucian Freud?
Mm-hmm.
Fine art specialist that I'm sure had Lucian Freud. Mm-hmm. Yeah, they were two brothers. Yeah, Clement just appeared in the newspaper recently. They were both dead now. Anyway, I can't remember which one died first. I think one of them died first. Anyway, so there was a funeral, and a journalist who went to the funeral noticed that his brother, let's say it was Lucian, died first. And the journalist who went noticed that Clement wasn't at the funeral, and he couldn't understand why. So he went along to interview Clement and said, why didn't you go to your brother's funeral? And he said, well, I didn't feel any reason to go, but he was your brother. Yeah, I know, but we haven't spoken for 60 years. Why not? I can't remember now. When we were growing up as teenagers, we got into an argument about something, and we didn't make up. And then I went to this university, he went to that one, I did this, and he did that. And we just grew apart. We never saw each other again, we never wrote to each other. No. And the longer, the more time went by, the more difficult it was to pick up the phone, or to go have dinner with each other, etc., etc. And now I just have no feeling from him whatsoever. And I didn't feel any need to go. Yeah. And sometimes it's like that, isn't it? People just drift apart. The years go by. You don't see your cousin or your uncle or your aunt or your brother or your sister for years, decades sometimes. Yeah? And the longer it takes, the more time has gone past, the more difficult it is to make the effort. Yes? To make up. Yeah, so anyway, Jacob then, after 21 years, he decided to go home. But before going home to Isaac and Rebekah, he decided he's going to go and meet Esau. Why? Why did you decide? Why did you go to meet Esau?
To resolve the heart, because he understands Esau.
Yeah.
Esau's heart is broken.
Yeah, if you want to go make up with Esau, you realize, actually, I really offended my older brother. I was such a stupid younger brother. I stole my older brother's birthright. I now understand why he's so upset and angry. I have to go make it up with my older brother. I can't go home and see mum and dad, because the first thing they're going to say is, did you make it up with your older brother? Yes? So I want to go, when I go and see mum and dad, I want to be able to tell them, yes, I'm reconciled with my older brother, we made up. And do you think Isaac and Rebecca would be happy to hear that?
Yeah.
What makes parents more happy than anything else?
Happy children.
When the children are happy, getting on with each other, yes? That's what parents want more than anything else, is for children to be happy, get on with each other, to meet up for birthdays and Christmas and etc., etc. They want to make their parents happy as well. But also he felt this moral obligation. I offended my older brother, I need to go restore my relationship with my older brother. So he sent the messengers expecting his older brothers to put on a party. Well, the messengers returned to Jacob saying, we came to your brother Esau, he's coming to meet you with 400 men with him. Jacob was greatly afraid and distressed. So he realized, gosh, my older brother, he still bears this grudge against me. After 21 years, he still holds this grudge against me. He's coming to meet with 400 men. So Jacob then was afraid. He's afraid he might get killed. He's afraid there might be a confrontation. He's afraid he might end up killing his own Esau, depending on how the fight went. So what could Jacob have done then?
Forget it.
Yeah, forget it. Well, that's the way he feels. If he hasn't got over it, he hasn't, moved on. Forget it, I'm just going to go and see mom and dad. But he didn't do that, did he? At the risk of his life, he went forward to meet his older brother because he felt conscience-stricken. I have to make it up with my older brother, even at the risk of my life. Yeah? So he did that. So he developed a strategy. He divided everything he had in two. Sent half of what he had to Esau as gifts, and then he had this wrestle with the angel. So, what do you think that was? Wrestling with the angel. What's going on here in reality?
Overcome the archangel.
What does that mean in real life?
I mean,
he's got to go and meet his older brother. How does he feel?
He's afraid.
Mm-hmm. Afraid, yeah. He's afraid. Okay? Now, if he goes to meet his older brother, looking afraid and smelling of fear, what happens next? Has to be at peace with himself, yes? He has to radiate peace such that his brother is influenced by this peace that is emanating and coming from Jacob. But in order to be able to do that, he has to wrestle with all these demons and these fears he has with himself and come to terms with these things. Yes? That's not easy. If you're afraid of a dog, what does the dog do?
Bites you.
Bites you, yes? So, but if you're at peace with yourself, you're not afraid, the dog ignores you. That's the way it works. So Jacob then, victory over the angel, is wrestling with himself, with his fears and his nightmares and all these things, and with the image of Jacob that he saw that was coming towards him, just to be able to love Esau unconditionally, embrace Esau, and to be completely at peace with himself. Okay, then the next morning, Jacob went on bowing himself to the ground 7 times until he came near to his brother. But Esau ran to meet him, embraced him, fell on his neck, and kissed him, and they wept. So what's going on here? Jacob bowed to the ground 7 times.
He's showing the humility that he never showed before to his sister.
Okay, so when Esau sees what's happening, how does Esau read what is going on?
It's really changed.
My brother's changed, yes, and?
He's sorry.
What is Jacob actually doing through his actions?
For you.
He's respecting the older brother. Respecting the older brother again as the
eldest one. Okay, now remember, what was the
blessing?
What was the blessing that Isaac wanted to give to Esau that Jacob stole?
Material
and
power.
May the sons of your mother bow down before you. So what Jacob's doing, Jacob's returning to Esau the blessing he stole from Esau. He's giving to Esau material wealth, half of all his cows and cattle and sheep and goats, and he's bowing down to his older brother 7 times. So he's enacting the blessing that he stole. So by doing that, he's returning to Esau the blessing he stole from Esau. So Jacob then is becoming a good younger brother, yes? And that's why Esau realizes he's sorry. But he's not just saying sorry, he's actually restoring and giving back what he stole. That's real restoration, giving back what he stole by enacting it, yes? And the conversation, amazing. What do you mean by all this company, all these cows and sheep which I met? Jacob said, to find favor in the sight of my Lord. So he's treating his older brother with great respect, this language. Esau says, I have enough, my brother. Keep what you have for yourself. This is all edited, but with reading the original. Jacob says, I pray you, if I found favor in your sight, then accept my present, the Hebrew word is saying the blessing, accept my blessing, from my hand. For truly to see your face is like seeing the face of God. So he's looking up to and hero worshiping his older brother. To see your face is like seeing the face of God, yes? Being a good younger brother, looking up to his older brother. With such favor you've received me, accept, I pray, my gift that is brought to you because God has dealt graciously with me and because I have enough. Not, oh, look, I've worked really hard, I've done so well, I'm going to give this to you, but very humble, God has dealt graciously with me, yes? So he's taking that position of a good younger brother. And so Esau then is easily able to be a good older brother. So Jacob then is making it easy for Esau to overcome his fallen nature. That makes sense? That's the role, you know, it's responsibility on both sides to make it easy for the other to overcome their fallen nature. And so Jacob then made a huge progress. He had all this fallen nature, he's arrogant and stuck up and deceitful and etc. etc. And going through his 21 years, he reflected upon his life and he changed, yes? And he came back as a good younger brother. And it made it easier for Esau to forgive him, yeah? And overcome his fallen nature. Make sense? Okay, so that's all that. And so they make this lasting foundation of God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. What happens next? Well, Jacob and Esau, they go their separate ways. And they meet up once more and vow to bury Isaac when he dies. And Esau becomes an ancestor of Edomites, that's that red splotch there. And Jacob settles in Canaan, which is to the north of it. Yeah. And their descendants were enemies for many hundreds of years. And eventually the Edomites are converted to Judaism forcibly about 200 years before the birth of Christ. So did Jacob and Esau make the foundation substance? Jacob and Esau to fulfill the indemnity condition to remove the fallen nature. Esau needed to love Jacob. Did Esau love Jacob?
Yeah,
he loved him and forgave him. Did Esau need to respect him? Did Esau respect Jacob at the end?
Yeah.
Yeah, with the